we were discussing in the last class. One second. Okay, students, let's start the class. In the last class, what we were discussing was, we were talking about Unitaria, right? We have started the kingdom Monera, and as we have discussed previously, Monera, kiman types of Monera we have talked about? Around 8 types of Monera, right? And out of the 8 types, 5 types we need to talk in details. And so, basically, Eubacteria to me, pohibole. We have started Eubacteria by drawing the Eubacterial cell or the bacterial cell. So, structure of a prokaryotic cell, we have already drawn. We have talked about the different parts that are present inside the cell, the organelles, kind of key functions, like special importance to words like mesosomes or structures like mesosomes, right? Then we had also discussed something about plasmid. We have talked about the envelope also. Talking about the envelope, key moment, it is made up of, as per our diagram, no, it is made up of 3 layers. Our outermost layer to keep it was like capsule, and inner capsule is the cell wall, and inner to cell wall is obviously the cell membrane, right? And something about the capsule, keep on the cells, then not necessarily all bacteria will have a capsule. Instead of a capsule, they might have a side layer also. Presence of a capsule makes the bacterial cell dash. It makes the bacterial cell virulent, right? A virulent means disease-causing property. Is called as virulence, right? So, we can look at the cell wall or structure. How does the cell membrane look like, right? We have talked about, so bacterial cell wall, it is made up of the chief component. What is the chief component? Janaki, if you are talking about the plant cell wall, no? Plant cell wall or chief component key, cellulose. Thick Janaki, bacterial cell wall or chief component key. Bacterial cell wall is made up of, what is that word that we use? It is peptidoglycan. Very good. So peptidoglycan, we have read about the peptide part and the glycan part. We have talked about certain things called DEPA, right? We have talked about cell wall, tapsaticoic acid. Ajami kasotnikur, we are starting it from the staining in bacteria, right? So we have already got the notes, no? PDF already paisa. So, and I think you all have gone through it also. So starting with staining in bacteria, no? Right? Staining in bacteria means you apply a particular stain to a bacteria. Now, the first thing is, why do you stain a bacteria? Eta bacteria, kami stain kyo koribo lage? There could be 2 answers for that. First is, if you want to really see the contents inside the cell, no, at a cell, so bacteria are iman puru microscopic at a organelle. So to see the inside content, obviously, I mean, stain koile ki hobo, it will be clearer. That would be one answer. Second answer is just to identify whether the bacteria is gram positive or gram negative. I think you remember we have already said about this. The jinmila bacteria gram stain to retain correct, gram positive, arjuna retain no correct, those are called as gram negative. So, staining part of the first point that's given in your PDF, obviously the name of the scientist, no? Scientist of Christian Graham. So, that is a tick mark, Christian Graham, the procedure, right? He has worked upon it. Next, question 9, what is the stain used? The stain used is also called as Graham stain or Graham stain oblique kiba kibi likha hase.
Crystal.
Crystal violet.
It is called as crystal violet or it is called as arutase. Something that starts with G. Gentian violet, right? So, staining process of key, you have to take the bacteria. Not taking the bacteria, can you get over? Bacteria, you have to take the bacteria. But how will you take it? You cannot just go and pick a bacteria and then stain it. So generally what we do, we collect the drop, we collect the sample where the bacteria is present. We take a drop of water, and in that water, obviously the bacteria is present. That drop of water is applied or placed in a glass slide. Glass slide or ami ki koru, smearing koru. Right? So PDF of first word to ki likhi ase, so bacterial smear bully likhi ase. Is the word smear understood? staining process to ulai sam epdf of
yes
yes ma'am
right so the first word that we have written in there is key. Bacterial smear, right? So smear boli boli ki bujbo. Okay, the process is have you heard something called as smearing? Amane ki hol so bacteria to ami one drop of water we have taken it and we have put it in a glass slide, right? Next what to do, he glass cone slider upor di with another glass slide to slide it down, right? So ultimately what happened, you apply pressure with another glass slide, and this process is called smearing. Ekhon glass slide ase, right? Suppose this is a glass slide. Glass slide will be put a drop of water containing bacteria with another glass slide. Ami ki ko ghongi diu eneke, so that the bacteria gets stuck to the glass slide. So this is what is called smearing, right? After smearing, the next step is air drying, right? Okhon dry koribo libo because obviously we do not need the water content, we need the bacteria, and then the procedure or the steps as written in the PDF, right? So first, ami hetu koru. Smear coat as air dry coat. Type so that we bacteria to be apply coat crystal violet. We apply it for 30 seconds. After that, what next? Same coat. This one, command day it for you. No, type before. Ki koi se? Or is something I supposed to do?
Then last week, but
once it is stained, then. Meaning to keep that the bacteria is stained by two stains, first with crystal violet and then with iodine. Once the CDI complex is formed, it is again washed. Ebar kihere wash koise?
Alcohol.
Once it was washed alcohol. With water, now it is washed with alcohol. Only after washing it with alcohol, we will be able to identify whether there is gram positive or gram negative. After washing it with alcohol, jodi bacteria stain to retain kori thake, it has that ami ki boli kom gram positive, and obviously it will appear blue in color or violet or purple in color. And after washing it with alcohol, if suppose the bacteria does not retain the stain, then they will be marked as gram negative, right? It is ekhi portion of question ki hai. First to question is a gram stain scientist associated, so Christian gram valuable label. Second, the name of the stain. Tinta naam koisu belek belek belek. So we have to know the names, right? Crystal violet, gram stain, gentian blue, gentian violet, etc. 18 tana. Third is, at a question I say, in order to identify, no, if it is a gram positive or it's a gram negative, unto step out piece of identify koribo paro. After washing it with water or after washing it with alcohol. So you have to remember that it is only after washing it with alcohol. That's the third point. Fourth point is, question to ahead, do gram negative bacteria take in gram stain? Gram negative bacteria gram stain loin and alloy. What would be the answer? They take in gram stain but they do not retain. Is the point understood? Lua gram positive gram negative retain retain all gram positive hai koribo gram negative hai retain koribo nware. So question to diya hai, do gram stain, is gram stain taken in the gram negative bacteria? Yes, it is taken, but they cannot retain. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Right, next, gram negative bacteria bilako apko jehetu retain koribo nware, they have to be stained again by re-stain koribo leba. And this time another stain that we are using is kuntu stain use for gram negative o karne saffronin, right? Our saffronin add color loge loge, you'll see that the bacteria appears pink in color. So this was all about the staining process. Staining or bikoyaro difficult alage. But already the important point for you, so it's good that you mark it down, right? After that, what we have is shapes of bacteria, no? Right? Jeto note to diya ase bhalke. There's no point of writing it down. Just follow the note or follow the period. When we talk about shapes, four basic steps shapes thake, no? Bacteria boli kole. What are the four basic shapes? coccus, bacillus, vibrio, aru, spiral, right? Okay, coccus boli kole round shape, bacillus kene kwa rod shape, yeah, vibrio is
coma shape,
aru spiral is obviously
shape, I think.
Right? Huh? Yeah. So these are the four basic shapes of bacteria. Now, apart from this shape, so what we have to talk is when we talk about the particular shape called as coccus. Coccus or logot, aru kisuman, as far as how many bacteria are present in that association. Etake bacteria to okole ase, ne tahande group form kori ase. Accordingly, they will have certain names. Coccus or classification ase, bacillus or classification ase. Before going into classification, out of these four types, so what's a common kuntu? Which shape is supposed to be most common? Kuntu common. Coccus, bacillus, vibrio, spiral. Kuntu supposed to be common bacteria?
Bacillus.
Bacillus. Right? Yeah, bacillus is the most common form. Now, as I said, if you're talking about coccus, no? Coccus is round shape. Talking about the group to kiman ase, we have certain words called as monococcus, diplococcus, tetracloccus, etc., etc. Right? So, PDF of page number 2, unwa? So, monococcus will be called again, okay? What we answer? Yeah. Monococcus. So, we understand. Coccus forms obviously round hobo, mono mane ki, single. So, if the bacteria remains in our singly, and it is round in structure. Tell me, what do we call monococcus? Okay, tell me, I am using diplococcus. Tell me, what is coccus? Is it a diploma? Is it a so? Tell me, what is it? What is important? Hekini, yeah, in a pair. So, hekini point. Examples important. Will you write it?
Okay.
Right. Okay. Next, mono diplo. After KFS, so some strepto. Right? So examples are upor to question ahibo pare, but terms pilaka upor to question ahibo pare. For example, diagram based question ahibo pare, you need to identify. So obviously you can identify this is monococcus, this is diplococcus. Next we have a word called as streptococcus.
Tetracoccus.
Right? A streptococcus or a tetracoccus also we have, yeah. Streptococcus, okay. Right? Streptococcus, the streptobacillus. Coccus is something that we understand. Strepto, what we need to know is, whenever we use the word strepto, we understand that they are in the form of a chain. Right? They be bacteria kini. Eta degate. Chain form kori pala eta structure form kori ase. Iti hale ami tak word to use for strepto. So if it is streptococcus, then we understand that coccus type of bacteria are forming a chain-like structure. And if you are using the word streptobacillus, then you understand that rod-shaped bacteria are in the form of a chain. It's the point here. All you need to remember is the meaning of strepto. Strepto mane ki. So if you know this meaning, jodi identification question hai, but diagnostic question hai, a to diagram dekhile, you have to remember that it's like a chain, and so we are talking about strepto. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next, we have tetra. Tetra is very simple because we have a selection of four round of coccus bacteria. That is called tetracoccus. So, monococcus, diplococcus, streptococcus, tetracoccus. Next, we have staphylococcus. Staphylococcus is key mono rakhi bhai ye bracket of jinke term diya ase na pdf on so the bacteria would arrange themselves in a irregular bunch means what jeneke ami diplococcus or we were certain that only a pair of bacteria would be seen similarly when we are talking about tetracoccus we were certain that the sarita if you are talking about staphylococcus you will not have an idea about the number of bacteria present in such an organization because and plus what would be the format jeneke diplo boli kole logi thakibo strepto boli kole we have talked about the chain staphylo boli kole eko specific shape size or na thake they can stay in any way they want right so irregular bunch. Ek bunch kya use koi so kan group of thakibo. You don't have a specific shape, so we are using the word irregular. What is important? Again, the word staphylo. বুঝি পাইছো মনো ডিপ্লো টেট্রো দেন উই হ্যাভ সেফাইলো সেফাইলো মানে ইরেগুলার বাঞ্চ এন্ড নেক্সট উই হ্যাভ আ ওয়ার্ড কলড অ্যাজ সারসিনি সারসিনেট কি মনত রাখিবা যে এতিয়া কোকাস ব্যাকটেরিয়া বিলা কেনেকে অ্যারেঞ্জ হয়ে আছে ইন দ্য ফর্ম অফ আ কিউব রাইট আটটা থাকিব ইন দ্য ফর্ম অফ আ কিউব এন্ড কিউব লাইক অ্যারেঞ্জমেন্ট কি মনত রাখিম 18 নাম্বার ইন দ্য ফর্ম অফ আ কিউব এনেকুৱা যদি অ্যারেঞ্জমেন্ট হয়ে আছে অফ দ্য কোকাস ব্যাকটেরিয়া উই ইউজ দ্য ওয়ার্ড কল্ড অ্যাজ সারসিনি সো ইফ ইউ আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড দ্য মিনিং আই থিঙ্ক ইট উইল নট বি আ প্রবলেম টু আইডেন্টিফাই দ্য ডায়াগ্রামস সো কোয়েশ্চন যদি আহে আইডেন্টিফিকেশন বেসড আমি আইডেন্টিফাই কৰিব পাৰিম নে নোৱাৰিম কোকাস ডিপ্লোকোকাস স্ট্রেপটোকোকাস সেফাইলোকোকাস টেট্রাকোকাস আর সারসিনি কি মনত রাখিব লাগিব দ্য মিনিং অফ দ্য ওয়ার্ডস এনি কনফিউশন আপ টিল নাও
No, ma'am.
Okay. So this was about coccus. Similarly, we explained about bacillus also. So if you talk about bacillus, they are rod-shaped, right? And as we have mentioned before, they are most common type, no? Next is talking about flagella. Bacillus or ki monotrachy, but again, they are generally flagellated. নাছিলে এই পইণ্টটো মনত ৰাখিবা ঠিক তেনেকে আৰু কি মনত ৰাখিবা মোষ্ট কমন ফৰ্ম নেক্সট ইজ আগেইন ডিপেণ্ডিং অন দ্য এৰেঞ্জমেণ্ট যদি এনেকে আছে নে কেনেকে আছে ৰাইট মনো বেচিলাছ নে ডিপ্লো বেচিলাছ নে স্ট্ৰেপ্টো বেচিলাছ আই থিংক নাও ইউ আণ্ডাৰষ্টেণ্ড চেইন ফৰ্মত যদি আছে তেতিয়াহ'লে তাক আমি কি বুলি কওঁ স্ট্ৰেপ্টো বেচিলাছ ইয়াতে বেচিলাছৰ যেতিয়া চাইজ বহি আছা এটা ফৰ্মৰ ওপৰত কোৱেশ্যন আহিছে বেছিকে পেলিছেড লাইক ইয়াৰ ওপৰত কোৱেশ্যন আহিছে ঠিক আছে ইয়াৰ ওপৰত কোৱেশ্যন কি আছে ফাৰ্ষ্ট ইয়াৰ পৰা আণ্ডাৰষ্টেণ্ড পেলিছেড কি ৰড শ্বেপ বেক্টেৰিয়াবিলাক যদি ওৱান আফটাৰ আনাডাৰ দে আৰ এৰেঞ্জ ইন দিছ ৱে অলমষ্ট লাইক এৰেঞ্জমেণ্ট ইন আ মেট্ৰিক্স তেতিয়াহ'লে তাক আমি কি বুলি কওঁ পেলিছেড ম্যাট্রিক্স বিলাক যেনেকে এরেঞ্জ কৰো ন এটাৰ পিছত এটা এটাৰ পিছত এটা তেনেকে যদি আমি এরেঞ্জ কৰা আছে এনেকুৱা ধৰণৰ এটা স্ট্রাকচাৰ দেখা পাওঁ তেতিয়া তাক আমি কি বুলি কওঁ পেলিছেড সো হোৱাট ইউ নিড টু ৰিমেম্বৰ ইজ দ্য ওয়ার্ড So, K-black bacteria, Q is a they are Is the word understood? Understood? Right? So, 8 over both question I say. Either the heat would be this one, right? So, question to domestic arrangement bullies are given or line side by side or maybe diagrammatic to the whole diagram B. দুটা পইণ্ট জানিব লাগিব শেপছৰ পৰা দ্য মিনিং অফ দ্য ৱৰ্ড সো দেট ডায়াগ্রাম বেসড কোয়েশন আহিলে আমি বুঝি পাওঁ এন্ড সেকেন্ড ইজ এক্সাম্পল নেক্সট নাম্বার অফ ফ্লাজেলা ইজ দ্য নেক্সট টপিক সো ইউ আর টকিং অ্যাবাউট ফ্লাজেলা ফ্লাজেলা কি হয় উই হ্যাভ অলরেডি রেড অ্যাবাউট ইট নো কি হয় হেয়ার লাইক স্ট্রাকচার ইফ ইউ রিমেম্বার দ্য ডায়াগ্রাম Right? Hair-like structure. Next is talking about flagella. What would be the number of flagella in a bacteria? Ata bacteria, kiman flagella thakibo? Not to say that each and every bacteria will have just one single flagella or they will have double flagella, right? Depending on tahatar flagella kini kota se, from which point of the cell this flagella arises and what is the number also. Sometimes this is also considered. Accordingly, tahatar ki kori se, the name has been given on the basis of flagella. Right? I think you have gone through the note or that kisman word likha se, no? Jene ke কে মনোট্রাইকাস সো এটা ব্যাকটেরিয়া আছে তাতে মাত্র এটা কর্নার বা এটা এজর পৰা এডাল ফ্লেজেলা ওলাইছে ইফ ওয়ান ফ্লেজেলা দেন অবভিয়াসলি ইট ইজ নট মনোট্রাইকাস সিমিলারলি ইফ ইউ হ্যাভ আ রাশিয়ান ব্যাকটেরিয়া উইথ নো ফ্লেজেলা তেতে হল তাক আমি কি বলি কম আর্থ্রাইটিস রাইট সো আর্থ্রাইটিস মনোট্রাইকাস নেক্সট উই হ্যাভ কি এমফিট্রাইটিস এমফি মানে কি What is the meaning of amphi? Amphi means both. So you can see the flagella arising from both the parts of the bacteria, right? So what is the dolphin? Amphi is the first point. It is both. Second is, how many number of flagella? One each from each end. One each from each end. Next we have, cephalotrichus. So cephalotrichus of TSL, there are two or more flagella that arises from one end. Right? Yet I call dudal no dibo pariba. Without flagella, one flagella at one end, one flagella each at both ends, two or more flagella at one end, that is called as cephalo. Then we have lofo, two or more flagella at both ends. Okay, and next we have peritrichus, where you see the flagella developing from the entire body surface. মই লিখি দিয়া নাই কারণ নোটসটো আগতে পাইছা, right? Examples of দিয়া আছে. Again, from this part, examples are not important. Any kind of question মই দেখা নাই যে give an example or identify the example of lophotrichus or identify the example of arthritis bacteria. Generally, any kind of questions are not. Questions can arise regarding the diagrams, right? Diagrams and the meaning. Question to ahiba pare, a bacteria having more than one flagella at both ends is called as ki boli koba tetia. More than one flagella at both ends ki boli koi?
Lophotrichus.
So keneke poribo lagibo he bostu tu likhi thoi diba thik ase examples important no hoy important ki diagrams kini aru meaning eta arthritis means for a flagella with a bacteria with any flagella is called as arthritis right a flagella with one a bacteria with one flagella at both the end amphitrichus initially poriba tar upori all this maximum question has been asked about peritrichus right a bacteria having flagella all over its body is called as peritrichus clear okay so cytology diagram and meaning of the words are important next we move to structure of flagella Talking about structure of the flagella, can you see it? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Right. So when we talk about the flagella, flagella to kya thake? Tinta part thake. And what are the three parts?
Basal
the body. Base,
basal body.
Yeah,
hook.
The hook,
hook.
And
filament.
Okay. As far as the structure is concerned, I mean, ekine information actually NCERT book of diya ase. Okay. Tar upore kini jonkini ami kom. This is little bit extra, but sometimes eta question moi aha dekhisu something about the ring. Not very commonly asked. Iman basically commonly khuda na question di. Okay, sir. So jigita likha ase ekini ami bhalke pori. Apart from that, key question hai sir. If you are talking about the base, no? Basal body ba basal body ba base part boli kole which part are you thinking of if you are talking about this as the bacteria no flagella to corpora arise korisile cell envelope ami last time akisilo three layers we have drawn. Flagella kunto layer pra draw korisu. Etu pra, etu pra, etu pra. Just try to remember. Something like this. Yes. So from the cell wall. So in our diagram, we have shown base of the flagella. Base mane junkini lagi ase. Base of the flagella in the cell wall. But we see, if you want to see it properly, we will see that a part of the flagella also remain attached to the cell membrane with the help of certain rings. So basal body ki thake ketaman rings thake. Ei rings bila kor through e, they remain attached with the cell wall and also with the cell membrane, right? So ei duta ring would be considered as the outer ring. আৰু এইটোক আমি কি বুলি কওঁ দ্য ইনাৰ ৰিং এল পি এছ এম আছিলে ন এল পি এছ এম নেমছ অফ দ্য ৰিং নট ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট ৰাইট চ' আউটাৰ ৰিং আৰু ইনাৰ ৰিং চ' ৱাট উই আণ্ডাৰষ্টেণ্ড বাই দিছ ৱৰ্ড আউটাৰ ৰিং মানে কি আউটাৰ চাইডে থাকিব আউটাৰ মানে উই আৰ টকিং এবাউট আইডাৰ দিজ ৰিংছ আৰ এটাচ টু দ্য চেল ৱাল অৰ ইট ইজ এটাচ টু দ্য চেল মেমব্ৰেইন যোনটো নেকি চেল ৱালত এটাচ হৈ আছে তাক আমি কি বুলি কৈছো আউটাৰ যোনখিনি ৰিংছেৰে চেল মেমব্ৰেইনত এটাচ হৈ আছে তাক আমি কি বুলি কৈছো ইনাৰ ইজ দ্য পইণ্ট আণ্ডাৰষ্টুড
Yes, ma'am.
Right? And the point that is important is if you are talking about gram positive, only the inner pair is present. Swa, buji paisane nai. Gram negative bacteria, duita pair thakibo, right? Duita pair mane, outer pair, inner pair. Gute sarida thakibo, gram positive ot ki thake, it is only the inner pair. Kini line to kobat mark kori thoi diya, aro nohole likhi luwa. Kiba questions ithia lake? So, as I said, no, about the question, I said, bili kosilu, So it is about this point, the gram positive of kuntu pair thake, both ne only either. Buji paisa no? Okay. Next, according to your PDF, PDF on us, yes, the next part to
Pili.
Yeah, you have Pili, that is in case of a 6-7. Pili is something that we have already discussed. Pili kotha kosilu nai. Ki kosilu Pili kotha? First, you have to understand what a Pili is. A Pili is nothing but a hair-like structure. When we have drawn the prokaryotic cell, we have seen the presence of three hair-like structures, adult flagella, adult pili, or adult fimbri, a short hair and a longer hair, and the flagella. Flagella, locomotory organ, pili or fimbri, locomotion of help, or in and offer it. Does a pili or a fimbri help the prokaryotic cell in locomotion?
No, ma'am.
In attachment or in conjugation, etc. So we have talked about Pili. We are not going to discuss any more about Pili. Right. Next part is gram positive or gram negative or difference. Yeah. Out of all the points, no, there are certain points that we know: gram positive cell wall, gram negative cell wall. One type of bacteria retains the color; the other type of bacteria does not retain the color, etc. So there are certain general points and there are certain important points. Important points like mark for it. Important points mark for number three. Right. So number three, number. Oh, that is number three and number two. It is, I don't know, given in your PDF. The point is, it is not covered by a liposaccharide layer. Hey, point is important. So if you remember the diagram of cell wall that we have drawn, peptidoglycanor uporot liposaccharide asile, or eta diagram of peptidoglycanor uporot liposaccharide asile. If liposaccharide outer layer is present, then obviously that is the cell wall of gram negative. And if only peptidoglycan is present, liposaccharide ki kot ase tar bhitor pine inner side, then that is the diagram of gram positive cell wall. Can you identify or can you recognize the diagram? Or can you remember the diagram that we have drawn in our previous classes? Peptidoglycanৰ ওপৰত আৰু এটা লেয়াৰ ৰাখিছিলো নাই গ্ৰাম নেগেটিভত Okay, so that point is important. Next is the point called about muramic acid. Muramic acid or percentage car basic, gram positive ne gram negative, that is important. Third would be obviously ticoic acid we have talked about. Ticoic acid is a characteristic of positive and negative. What happened? You all forgot? No, you all don't feel like saying or responding.
I'm gram positive.
What about the rest of the students? Ki hol? Scared niki? Porikha date ahise karne? Don't get scared. Have confidence in yourself. You'll have studied good. Okay, this is just like a revision. So study hard and try to understand, remember, okay. So, ticoic acid was present in gram-positive, absent in gram-negative. Again, we talk about DEPA. DEPA is a characteristic of, obviously, gram-negative, absent in case of gram-positive. So, egita point will important. As far as sensitive to antibiotics is concerned, kunto besi sensitive hobo?
Gram-positive.
Gram-positive. Kiho karne? Right. Generally, because they might not have the capsule, right? And the general maximum forms of slime layer to dekha paise, right? And whereas in gram negative, the maximum of the gram negative bacteria they have a capsule, and so they are not so sensitive to penicillin. So, egita point important. Baki kini okay. Another point is about pili. Pili usually absent in gram positive and is a chief characteristic of or very commonly present in gram negative. So, jungita point korse, egita point tick koriba. And obviously, the examples. Next, talking about protoplasm, cytoplasm, nucleoid, it along with the diagram we have said, we have already talked about plasmid, the different types of plasmid like F plasmid, R plasmid, POL plasmid, TI plasmid. In the last class, we discussed this. One understand it, right? What is plasmid? The extra genetic material is called plasmid, right? Plasmid or ki thakibo? Obviously genes thakibo. So at a particular gene thakile, if suppose the F gene or the fertility gene is concerned, then that is called as F plasmid. If POL gene is present, it is called as POL plasmid. R gene is present, it is called as R plasmid, etc. Right? Plasmid or plasmid?
No, ma'am.
Junto bacterial cell or F plasmid thakibo, that bacterial cell will be considered as a male or a female. Keep it considered. Fertility gene, if it is present, then it should be said to be as okay. Male or female. Obviously, it will be considered as a male, right? Next is, we have to talk about the life process of bacteria, right? So bacteria occurs, life process, and within that heading, growth, so growth of bacteria, nutrition in bacteria, respiration in bacteria, and the last one is reproduction in bacteria. So, egita life process we need to study. That is, we started with growth. Talking about growth, what we know that the bacteria can be grow or is found in almost every places. No, so ubiquitous word that I am use for is inside the body of an organism, outside the body of an organism, so both the bacteria would buy. Apart from that, they could be grown in the laboratory conditions also, but in a lab also. Jedi at a bacteria lab or grow for you like it, then you could grow for it in a culture medium. Culture medium could be solid culture medium, liquid culture medium, etc., etc. Culture medium, I mean tissue culture, we will be discussing at that time. So bacteria ki ho normally ho thake, aur ami lab to grow for you paro, and under using culture medium. And this temperature to go, we have already written it down now. 35 degrees Celsius, best pH 7. Right. Next is, whenever we talk about growth, no? Growth, suddenly, I mean, if you have a graph, no? Eta bacteria, bacteria growth, to I study this, right? First thing, what do you understand by growth of a bacteria? Bacterial growth, maniki. A bacteria is growing. What we understand by that?
Cell division.
It is? Cell division, right? We don't say that if you're talking about one bacteria and we say that this bacteria is growing, we are not mentioning or we are not talking about it growing in size, right? Eta pora ki hobo? Duta hobo, dutar pora sarita hobo, and then this is what is called as growing or cell division. Right. So now, if we are reading about the growth of a bacteria, our bacteria to growth to keneke hoise, all the information, if we are plotting it in a graph, right? Are you understanding? Ami eta bacteria nisu, bacteria to growth hoise, and we are studying the growth. And whatever the result that we have found it from the study, we have placed it in a graph. And this graph shows that bacterial growth to keneke dekhabo. বুঝি পাইছানে আমাৰ স্টাডিটো যদি আমি এখন গ্ৰাফত প্লট কৰো ৰাইট তেতিয়া হলে এই বেক্টেৰিয়াটোৱে যে গ্ৰো কৰিছে এটা দুটা হৈছে দুটাৰ পৰা চাৰিটা হৈছে চাৰিটাৰ পৰা আঠটা হৈছে এই গ্ৰোথটো দিছ কুড বি ৰিপ্ৰেজেণ্টেড ইন আ ফৰ্ম অফ আ গ্ৰাফ দেট ইজ এচ শেপ এণ্ড দিছ ইজ কল্ড এজ ৱাট sigmoid curve, yes or no? So question ahe, bacterial growth is represented by dash S-shaped curve. Ne S-shaped curve, ne J-shaped curve. S-shaped and J-shaped curve, if suppose you have read the ecology portion, no? Ecosystem, organism and population, if that factors the pohisa, sate kiswan bostu ase. Exponential growth. I don't know whether you remember or not. S shape or J shape? Do you know? One graph is one graph or curve to S shape, or one graph or curve to J shape. What does it indicate? What indicate? Kore. Okay, we'll come to J shape later. As of now, talking about bacteria. Bacterial growth hai kenuka dekhai S shaped curve dekhai, that is called as a sigmoid curve. Talking about the sigmoid curve, obviously it has certain phases. Kiki phases sir?
Lag phase.
Lag phase, log phase, then stationary phase. Right?
Okay.
Lag, log, stationary are that's of ultimately
death phase.
Death phase to go even consider nukorilo hobo. If you're talking about these three phases, no? Sigmoid curve local generally 18 phase associated, right? Leg, log, and stationary. What we understand by leg phase? Leg maniki. Lag has come from the word lagging behind, means what? Very slow. We talk about the growth of bacteria, the initial growth is very slow. Atarpra matto duta huise. Dutarpra ki huise? Sarita huise. Right? So it's very slow. So this phase where the growth is very slow is called as lag phase. And this is represented by this part of the graph. Ekdom initial phase two. Right? So sarita pra ki hobo? Anta hobo, anta pra kulota hobo, 16, then 32, then 64. And all of a sudden it increases. Right? So this increasing phase or exponential phase is called as the log phase, right? Log phase is the phase where maximum growth of the bacteria is observed. Growth rate slow in the lag phase, very high in the log phase. The exponential growth could be high, obviously, in the log phase. After the log phase, what happens is the growth gradually becomes stationary or it declines later. Now the question is, why does the growth declines or becomes stationary? NAKS se grow ko hi aise, no? NAKS growth ko hi aise. Why didn't the graph go like this? NAKS graph to no go pula. NAKS dekha kya ho gul? JD graph to NAKS go like that type of a graph would be called as what? The leg as a log as a and the log continued. That is what is called as J-shaped graph. And this one is called as S-shaped, right? So, leg phase, log phase, and then stationary. Why? Because other factors came into account, no? Eta bacteria is iman mon gose. Himan divide kore kore thakibo noware. Eta time of cube, obviously, it will become stagnant. Due to reasons like, maybe due to reasons like space, density of food, or any other limiting factor. Is the point understood? Infinite time or karne kitiyo grow koi thakibo noware. Karon factors like food, factors like space or any other factor, it will come into account. Aur jetiya jodi ebla factors it comes into account, tetiya hole ki hobo? Competition arambho hobo. Competition nahi arambho hole ki hobo? Obviously the survival of the fittest, right? So if it grows infinitely, then that is a J shape. J shape tumi kitiya dekho? Under abundant resources. একদম একো লিমিট নাই লিমিটলেস রিসোর্স যদি থাকে তেতিয়ালে সদায় জে শেপ কার্ভ হয় আর যদি উইথ আন্ডার আ লিমিটেড রিসোর্স থাকে তেতিয়ালে অবভিয়াসলি ইট উইল বি আ এস শেপ সো ফ্রম দিস পার্ট হোয়াট উইল নো ইজ ইফ ইউ আর টকিং অ্যাবাউট দ্য গ্রোথ অফ ব্যাকটেরিয়া ব্যাকটেরিয়াল গ্রোথ কার্ভ ইজ ডিনোটেড বাই ড্যাশ শেপ ইট ইজ ডিনোটেড বাই এস শেপ ডিনোট ফর আ সিম্পল কার্ভ আ সিম্পল কার্ভ হ্যাজ থ্রি ফেজেস দ্যাট ইজ দ্য লেগ ফেজ দ্য লগ ফেজ এন্ড দ্য স্টেশনারি ফেজ After the stationary phase, it will ultimately will be considering it as a death phase. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So life process first was growth and next respiration. Respiration in bacteria. Right. Whenever we use the word respiration and we talk about types of respiration, how many types of respiration we know? Not only in bacteria, yeah, it is always divided into two types. And what are the two types?
Aerobic and anaerobic.
Aerobic and anaerobic,
right. And the difference between aerobic and anaerobic is?
Obviously.
Respiration in presence of?
Oxygen.
In absence of
oxygen.
Right? This is a concept that we know. So in case of bacteria also, we will see aerobic bacteria, we will see anaerobic bacteria. But this aerobic and anaerobic is further divided. Aerobic ko ako dubhagat bhag kori se, anaerobic ko ako dubhagat bhag kori se. Ki kori se? First we have ki?
Obligate.
Obligate aerobes, the bacteria that shows aerobic respiration are called as aerobes, right? Obligate aerobes, or they are called as facultative aerobes. That is the first type. So aerobic bacteria divided into two types, obligate aerobes or aerobic bacteria duta part facultative aerobe hobo ne facultative
anaerobes.
Why not aerobes? Are you understanding the question? Ami kihor bhag kori aso aerobic or So aerobic or eta part ki obligate aerobes. Etu facultative aerobes kyo no hole? facultative anaerobic হৈ গ'ল
we can without oxygen থাকিব পাৰিম
exactly they can switch over right so by this term what we understand obligate aerobes or facultative aerobes we understand that these bacteria are strict in their nature strict in the sense ekhane bacteria jodi tumi without oxygen rakha then obviously they will not be able to survive right but this is a group of bacteria kenoka group these were originally aerobic bacteria but even in spite of lack of oxygen they can survive and so they are called as facultative mane ki oh sorry this is not facultative aerobes obligate aerobes or strict aerobes no okay facultative mane ki what is facultative ahomiya ta meaning ase no subidhabadi right bujhi paune na pa subidhabadi
yes
yes ma'am yes
ma'am. The situation yes, is stable we'll be moving to that part that is what is called as facultative no you can keep switching over you find it like suppose you like this class so you are here today you don't you like some other class you'll go to other class in the next day so you are not strict you can go anywhere you can keep on changing that is what is called as facultative so similar is the explanation in this case also in absence of oxygen the bacteria will die then they will be called as obligate but these were aerobic bacteria itself but even in spite of lack of oxygen they can survive so they are called as facultative so oxygen no hole tahate without oxygen u jiye thakibo pare right examples ki diya ase eta diya ase bacillus eta diya ase pseudomonas examples aba ha examples important similarly anaerobic again has been divided into obligate anaerobes aru facultative aerobes and anaerobes
aerobes
right ei duta word saba bhalke obligate anaerobes facultative anaerobes no hoy kintu obligate anaerobes facultative aerobes obligate anaerobes means what these bacteria will survive only in a place where there is no oxygen if you keep these bacteria in a place with oxygen then they will not be able to survive right facultative aerobes will a question hai facultative aerobes were originally ki bacteria facultative aerobes originally they are anaerobic bacteria but they can survive even in the presence of oxygen is the point here Clostridium. So, I'm not halke likhi diya na hai, ha? Because it's already there. There's no point of repeating. Aapko to tumhalke likhi bola lage, nahi likhi bola lagi bhai bilag bosso. Already to PDF on ase, ha na hoy. So that is the reason why I'm not writing it in a proper way. This is just the explanation part. So this is all about respiration. What we understand, respiration is always aerobic and anaerobic. Similarly, in bacteria also aerobic respiration, anaerobic respiration. Aerobic bacteria divided into two types: facultative anaerobes and obligate anaerobes. You have to know the meaning of obligate and facultative and the examples. Similarly, in case of anaerobic bacteria also obligate anaerobes, facultative anaerobes. Clear? Any questions? Okay. So life process, we have discussed about growth, we have talked about respiration. Next, we have to talk about nutrition. Nutrition in case of bacteria. Now talking about respiration, jeneke respiration is of two types. Nutrition could be divided into how many types?
Two types.
Yeah, not necessary. We are talking about bacteria. It could be any organism, right? Nutrition could be broadly divided into two types. That is autotrophic or heterotrophic. What is the meaning? Either the organism will prepare their own food or they will not prepare their own food. I think it's clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Autotrophic, heterotrophic, right? Autotrophic, they will prepare their own food. Heterotrophic, they will not prepare their own food. If they will not prepare their own food, from where will they get the food? Jedi nijor khabosto nije nobo nai kotha khabosto pabo
ami
hoti belegor depend kore and under depend kore. So we have certain terms for that, right? Either if they are not autotrophic, then heterotrophs hobo. Heterotrophs are types thakibo no je tahate khabosto palobo belegor palobo. If they are taking the food from a living host, right? So nijor khabosto nije nobo nai beleg eta living host or pra they take the food, or they can be taking the food from a dead host, or they can stay mutual collaboration with some other. Bujhi paisa what I said? If they do not prepare their own food, they'll take the food either from a living host, or they will take it from a dead host, or mutual collaboration of food lobo. You give me something, I'll give you something. Okay? So that type of a relation is obviously called as keep symbiotic, right? Next, talking about living host and dead host. If the organism take the food from a living host, the organism is said to be a dash keyword. The organism will become
a parasite.
That is called as a parasite. Very good. So if they do not prepare their own food, they either will be a parasite, or if they take it from a dead host, a cecum.
Saprophyte.
Understood, na? So this is the part that is understood. And if suppose mutually take, then they will be showing certain types of symbiotic relationship. Examples of each has been given in your PDF. Let's not write it down again. Meaning to examples important. Identify the parasitic bacteria, or maybe identify the saprophytic bacteria. So examples you need to read it, right? Next, coming to the autotrophs. So autotrophs means they will prepare their own food. So to prepare their own food, either they would be photoautotrophs, or they would be yes. Yes, khabosto bonabo in presence of light or in presence of chemicals. If they prepare their food in presence of light, they are called as photoautotrophs. If they prepare their food in presence or with the help of certain chemicals, by taking in certain chemicals, that is called as chemoautotrophs. Meaning to be like so.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, photoautotrophs or chemoautotrophs again have been further divided. Right? So photoautotrophs zuta category, chemoautotrophs zuta category. First is called as photolithotrophs or photoorganotrophs, and then we have chemolithotrophs and chemoorganotrophs. As a classification from Korise, these four categories are classified on the basis of what? On the basis of photolithotrophs, photoorganotrophs, classified on the basis of what? Is it clear? Photo, so autotrophs classified under two categories. On the basis of what? On the basis of either they will take in light or they will take in chemicals. If they take in light, they will talk. They will be called as photoautotrophs. So the chemical locally food prepare kore, that is called as chemoautotrophs. Coming to this section, photoautotrophs again are divided into two groups on the basis of what? On the basis of source of electrons and protons. Is that point clear? Understanding part, we'll do it later. Is this point clear? They are divided on the basis of what? On the basis of source of electrons or protons. Means what? Je tahate electron proton korbo. Khuabostu bonabo lagile. In order to make food, you need a source of electron and proton also. Right? So electron proton korbo loise. If the source of electron and proton is a, in organic substance, photolithotrop. If the source of electron and proton is an organic substance, then it is called as a photoorganotroph. Is the point clear?
Yes, ma'am.
If the electrons and protons come from an inorganic substance, it is called as photolithotroph. If the electrons and protons come from organic substance, it is called as photoorganotroph. Now the point is, electrons or protons are concept to key. What is the relation of electrons and protons and food making process or photosynthesis? Okay, forget about this part now. Try to remember the chapter photosynthesis that we are studying. Photosynthesis, I think you remember. Who undergoes photosynthesis?
Autotrophs. Green plants.
Green plants. So plants, right, perform photosynthesis. Is it only plants that perform photosynthesis? Is it only the green plants? It is also
the green algae.
Certain types of bacteria also, photosynthetic bacteria is a word that we have. Okay. Right? So whenever we talk about photosynthesis, kune kore? Green plants ko korbo pare, bacteria ko korbo pare. So bacterial photosynthesis and the normal photosynthesis, what is the similarity? Both will prepare food. Food in which form? Food in the form of carbohydrate. What is the difference? ক্লৰোফিল এটা পিগমেণ্ট হয় কিন্তু বেক্টেৰিয়াৰ ক্লৰোফিল উইল বি কলড বেক্টেৰিয়া ক্লৰোফিল আৰু ইন কেছ অফ প্লান্টস উই জাষ্ট ইউজ দ্য ৱৰ্ড ক্লৰোফিল ৰাইট সো অবভিয়াছলি ক্লৰোফিলটো থাকিবই light bacteria chlorophyll bully comami. So index to thakibo, that is not the difference. The difference is something else. Something about the requirement of photosynthesis. Adult plant photosynthesis koribo lagile, ki requirement ase. What do they require?
Plastid.
Yeah. Then requirement for photosynthesis. One of course. Photosynthesis. I'm not talking about bacteria. Now let's discuss about plants only. Yes, obviously carbon dioxide. You have talked about the chloroplast or the plastid. Aru?
Water, minerals.
Water. Right. Minerals is not generally we take into consideration because water logote minerals are that's different. Right. Carbon dioxide, water, chloroplast, what about sunlight? Asalte pahori bolu. Right? And obviously pigments. These are the five requirements. Chlorophyll, sorry. Carbon dioxide, water, the light. Next we have the pigment, and obviously the house photosynthesis is conducted. That is the chloroplast or the plastid. Egita hol pasta requirement. Now, what is the role of water in photosynthesis? Remember the reaction of photosynthesis. Photosynthesis bully kole in one reaction we can depict it, no? If you're talking about respiration also, in one reaction you can depict the entire process. photosynthesis reaction to kia hole carbon dioxide plus water will give you the glucose yes or no co2 plus h2 will give you C6H12O6 asile ne
yes ma'am
so the point is what will happen to carbon dioxide so eta reaction hoye ache ki hor bitor carbon dioxide and water bitor hei dukha react korar karone ki form koreche food form koreche it is only food that is prepared during our it is only food the only product of photosynthesis ne aru ki bata ulai
oxygen
whenever we see a reaction of this kind of carbon dioxide plus water in terms of photosynthesis then the out products ki hoy the food and oxygen right now the question is food or oxygen out of this kone form korbo carbon dioxide and water dui tai mili pelai ki kibata form korbo who is responsible for the production of oxygen कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड CO2 তাতো অক্সিজেন আছে প্লাস ওয়াটার H2O তাতো নিসেন্ট অক্সিজেন আছে তো আউটপুটত যোনটো আমি অক্সিজেন পাও এই অক্সিজেনটো কোনে রিলিজ করে বা হু ইজ রেসপন্সিবল কার্বন ডাইঅক্সাইড বা ওয়াটার
ওয়াটার
রাইট সো ইফ আই আস্ক ইউ হোয়াট ইজ দ্য রোল অফ ওয়াটার ইন ফটোসিনথেসিস হোয়াট উইল বি দ্য আনসার
To produce food and
oxygen. Yes. Okay. So, have you heard something called as photolysis of water?
Yes, ma'am.
Photolysis, water, Kunisa. The water molecule in presence of light, it gets broken down, right? And ultimately, it produces oxygen. Hey, to get only keep like photolysis. Photo means light. Lysis means breakdown. So you have the water molecule. It is light for a water molecule. Hangi pelai ki form kore.
Weights minus.
Is it only oxygen? Yeah, exactly. Okay, if you are talking, exam simple. We don't go for chemistry classes here. Okay, so we don't go for balancing and all those stuff. If water molecule is broken down, then ki form kore bo. Hoi ni no hoi?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear? Don't go for the balancing part. Don't go for nascent oxygen or O2, etc., etc. Balancing को बोलेगे ये तो दूसरा produce करोगे, ये तो दूसरा produce करोगे, ये half oxygen produce करोगे, हाँ ना? तो ऐसा है ये प्राकीमान हो बो, two और ये तो क्यों हो बो? Half of O2, yes or no?
Yes ma'am.
Okay.
Yes ma'am.
This is the part where we want oxygen and we do not want half of oxygen. Is that clear? আমার কি লাগে অক্সিজেন লাগে ফটোসিনথেসিস হলে কি উলাই অক্সিজেন হে উলাই নেসেন্ট অক্সিজেন উলাই নেকি হাফ অফ অক্সিজেন ইজ ইকুয়াল টু নেসেন্ট অক্সিজেন ইটসেলফ অকল এটা জিরো ও রাইট সো দিস ইজ আ পার্ট দ্যাট উইল ডু ইন ফটোসিনথেসিস উইল বি টকিং অ্যাবাউট হাউ মেনি ওয়াটার মলিকিউলস আর রিকোয়ার্ড টু রিলিজ ওয়ান মলিকিউল অফ অক্সিজেন এবলা আমি পিছত কই এজ অফ নাও ইফ ইউ সি দিস রিঅ্যাকশন প্রপারলি ওয়াটার মলিকিউলস গেটস ব্রোকেন ডাউন ইনটু কি H and E, electrons and protons, hoy na hoy?
Yes.
So can we say like this, that in the process of photosynthesis, a source of electron and proton is also very essential?
Yes, ma'am.
So if photosynthesis has to be conducted, there should always be a source of electrons and protons. Ete electron and proton ki hor karne lage? We'll talk about it. If you remember, for those students who remember that PS1 and PS2, cyclic photophosphorylation, non-cyclic photophosphorylation. Remember, na, the two steps of light reaction. At least, kori sa to, halke malon na tha kileo kotha nai. Kori sa to, light reaction, dark reaction, light reaction divided into two steps, cyclic photophosphorylation and non-cyclic photophosphorylation. Remember the older stuff. So,
yeah,
as of now. What I want to say is, for the process of photosynthesis to be conducted, you always need a source of electron and proton. In case of plants, who acts as a source of electron and proton? Water. Clear? Photosynthesis hobo lagile? ইলেকট্রনস এন্ড প্রোটনস লাগিব, কোনোবাই ইলেকট্রনস আর প্রোটনস ডোনেট করব লাগিব। প্ল্যান্টসর কেসত ইলেকট্রন প্রোটন ডোনেট কোনে করে? ওয়াটারে করে, রাইট? টকিং অ্যাবাউট ব্যাকটেরিয়াল ফটোসিনথেসিস, অ্যাজ আই সেড বিফোর, দেয়ার ইজ আ বেসিক ডিফারেন্স বিটুইন ব্যাকটেরিয়াল ফটোসিনথেসিস এন্ড প্ল্যান্ট ফটোসিনথেসিস। হোয়াট ইজ দ্য বেসিক ডিফারেন্স? দুটা ওয়ার্ড ইউজ করিম, অক্সিজেনিক, অ্যানঅক্সিজেনিক বা নন অক্সিজেনিক। কি বুঝি পাইছো? অক্সিজেনিক আর নন অক্সিজেনিক বা অ্যানঅক্সিজেনিক।
ব্যাকটেরিয়া অক্সিজেন রিলিজ না করে?
এক্স্যাক্টলি, ব্যাকটেরিয়ায় ফটোসিনথেসিস করে কিন্তু অক্সিজেন রিলিজ না করে। প্ল্যান্টস ফটোসিনথেসিস করে কিন্তু অক্সিজেন রিলিজ করে। সো ওয়ান ইজ অক্সিজেনিক ফটোসিনথেসিস, দা আদার ইজ নন অক্সিজেনিক ফটোসিনথেসিস, রাইট? নাও দা পয়েন্ট ইজ, হোয়াই ব্যাকটেরিয়া ডাজ নট রিলিজ অক্সিজেন? দা আনসার ইজ বিকজ ইট ডু নট ইউজ ওয়াটার। রিয়াকশনটোত প্লান্টসত যেনেকে আমি কার্বন ডাই অক্সাইড প্লাস ওয়াটার ইজ ইকুয়াল টু ফুড লিখিম, ব্যাকটেরিয়াত আমি কার্বন ডাই অক্সাইড প্লাস ড্যাশ ইজ ইকুয়াল টু ফুড। সেই ড্যাশটো কি আছিলে? H2S, রাইট? সো আলটিমেটলি ইমান ডিটেইলসত নাযাওঁ, ফটোসিনথেসিসত আমি ডিটেইলসত ডিসকাস কৰিম। এজ অফ নাও ৱাট আই ৱান্ট ইউ অল টু নো, ফটোসিনথেসিস হ'ব লাগিলে এটা সোর্স অফ ইলেকট্রনস প্রোটনস লাগিব। সেই সোর্স অফ ইলেকট্রনস প্রোটনস বিলাকে আলটিমেটলি বহুত রিয়াকশন করে 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 ইলেকট্রন প্রোটন বিলাকে আলটিমেটলি কি ফর্ম করব জানা? রিডিউসিং কো ফ্যাক্টর ফর্ম করব। ফটোসিনথেসিস রিডিউসিং কো ফ্যাক্টর করেছিলেন নাই? NADPH, রাইট? হোয়াট ইজ NADPH? আর রিডিউসিং কো ফ্যাক্টর, রাইট? NADP ইজ অলরেডি প্রেজেন্ট, ইট হ্যাজ টু গেট রিডিউস টু NADPH ডিউরিং হুইচ প্রসেস? ডিউরিং নন সাইক্লিক ফটোফসফোরিলেশন, বিকজ উই নো লাইট রিয়াকশন অর প্রোডাক্ট কি? ATP আর NADPH। সো NADPH হ্যাজ টু গেট ফর্মড, আর ইফ NADPH ইজ ফর্মড দেন ওনলি দ্যাট রিয়াকশন উইল গেট কন্ডাকশন উইল বি ওভার। সো আলটিমেটলি কি প্রোডাক্ট বিলাক ফর্ম করবলে কি লাগিব? ইলেকট্রনস প্রোটনস লাগিব। ইলেকট্রনস প্রোটনস কোথা পাব? একটা সোর্স লাগিব। সো ইন কেস অফ প্লান্ট উই নো দ্য সোর্স ইজ ওয়াটার, ইন প্লেস অফ ব্যাকটেরিয়া ইফ দ্য সোর্স ইজ আ অর্গ্যানিক সাবস্টেন্স দে উইল বি কল্ড অ্যাজ ফটো অর্গ্যানোট্রপস, ইফ দ্য সোর্স ইজ অ্যান ইনঅর্গ্যানিক সাবস্টেন্স দেন দে উইল বি কল্ড অ্যাজ ফটোলিথোট্রপস। আর দ্য টু ওয়ার্ডস ক্লিয়ার?
ইয়েস ম্যাম, ইয়েস ম্যাম,
right? So source of electron proton in case of this ki hobo? H2S. Ar yate ki hobo? Jikuno organic substance hobo, proteins hobo pare, right? Amino acids, proteins, jikwa, carbohydrates, etc. Clear?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Similarly, exactly the same explanation for this case also. Right, they will be using chemicals, obviously they will be using chemicals, and apart from that, they will require a source of electron and proton. If the source of electron and proton is an inorganic substance, chemoelectrotrophs, if the source is an organic substance, then they will be called as chemoorganotrophs. Right? Next, chemoelectrotrophs, sorry, photoelectrotrophs are after Dunaka Bhagkori se, no? Kiki? Example of photoelectrotrophs. গ্রিন টার্পল ব্যাকটেরিয়া আর পার্পল টার্পল ব্যাকটেরিয়া দেখিছান নাই? গ্রিন সালফার, পার্পল সালফার। গ্রিন সালফার এক্সাম্পল ক্লোরোবিয়াম, আর পার্পল সালফার ক্রোমেথিয়াম।
ক্রোমেথিয়াম,
right? Again, examples important, right? Identify the green sulfur bacteria, identify the green non-sulfur bacteria, purple sulfur, purple non-sulfur. We take the example here, so please read the examples carefully, right? So photoelectrotrophs, two categories. Similarly, photoorganotrophs also divided into two categories. KSLA, green non-sulfur or purple non-sulfur. Again, examples important. I think in the PDF it is given in the form of a chart. Read the chart properly. Any questions up till here? Clear?
Pigment or kotha koishil?
question hey to ma'am ki word use korise ma'am
bacteria viridin v-i-r-i-d-i-n bacteria viridin or bacteria purpurin p-u-r-p-u-r-i-n purple sunflower ki takibo bacteria purpurin p-u-r-p-u-r-i-n aru green sunflower ki takibo bacteria viridin v-i-r-i-d-i-n these are bacterial pigments that helps in photosynthesis right next is kiasle chemoautotrophs again divided into chemo lithotrophs aro chemo organotrophs chemo organotrophs ka eta example diya ase methane bacteria yes or no dekha paale
yes ma'am
chemolithotrophsot ki diya ase hydrogen bacteria example right hydrogen pneumonas ekdom important nahi not very important second example to important nitrifying bacteria important number 3 sulfur bacteria not very important kintu tathapi theobacillus example to important and fourth obviously iron bacteria example important right so egita example important boli likhi thoi dia tar bitor nitrifying bacteria upor maximum questions aise nitrifying bacteria is associated with what nitrogen fixation if you remember nitrogen cycle I think you have heard certain words called as nitrification denitrification unisa na nai
yes ma'am
nitrogen yes, cycle we know that atmospheric nitrogen has to reach the soil so that the plants can take it or no because the nitrogen that is present in the atmosphere is in unusable form for the plants usable forms hole convert korbo dibo and convert korile okay if I ask you in which form is nitrogen absorbed by the plants ki koba in which form or absorbable form or in which form nitrogen is absorbed by the plants atmosphere or nitrogen ki form of thake thaken thake right nitrogen kak lage plants hok lage plants se directly atmosphere ko nitrogen lobo pare ni nore nore
nore
nore kyo nore atmosphere kyo nore
em complex hote
complex ki kono hoy eneke ha ase ekoto iman complex form no hoy
em nitrogen jogo isopot na thake bhai mandalo नाइट्रोजन फिक्सेशन करे माटी
एक्जेक्टली बैक्टीरिया किसमाने नाइट्रोजन फिक्सेशन करे नाइट्रोजन फिक्सेशन माने
मैडम माटी इतलो पर माने तो खरल पदार्थ के निय जते हज एब्जॉर्बेबल सेटु गरे ल जाय माने गुड बिग बजन
exactly roba tumi ki kosa so ha bosuru ki na ekhini bosu jitu explain korino ahitu etu lesson or no hoy etu hol tumar mineral nutritional chapter no so anyway jehetu topic tu ulaise okoman bosuru bujhai dio ha so nitrogen first so nitrogen fixation mane ki tapkeo agote nitrogen fix kyo koribo lage nitrogen fixation mane atmospheric nitrogen tu kole anibo lagibo সয়লত আমি মিলাই দিব লাগিব কোনটো নাইট্রোজেন এটো নাইট্রোজেন এই প্রসেসটো আমি কি বলি কও ফিক্সেশন এই ফিক্সেশনটো এটমোস্ফিয়ারত কেনে কে আছে আনইউজেবল ফর্মত আছে এই আনইউজেবল ফর্মটো তুমি কি হলে কনভার্ট কৰিবা ইউজেবল ফর্মলে কনভার্ট কৰিবা এই প্রসেসটো আমি কি বলি কও ফিক্সেশন বলি কও ক্লিয়ার
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. It's a fixation. Yar pra yalo je ahibo. That is soil lot mix kori dibo a nitrogen do. Kune koribo.
Rhizobium.
Rhizobium.
Microorganisms. Rhizobium is one example of a microorganism. Jodi microorganism se a process to kore unusable or usable কামটো করে তেতিয়াহলে তাক আমি কি বুলি কম বায়োলজিক্যাল নাইট্রোজেন ফিক্সেশন বুলি কম যদি এই কামটো বেলেগে কৰিছে বাই ফিজিক্যাল মেথড তেতিয়াহলে তাক আমি ফিজিক্যাল নাইট্রোজেন ফিক্সেশন বুলি কম ইজ দ্য পয়েন্ট হিয়ার বায়োলজিক্যাল নাইট্রোজেন ফিক্সেশন ফিজিক্যাল নাইট্রোজেন ফিক্সেশন বায়োলজিক্যাল নাইট্রোজেন ফিক্সেশন কোনে কৰে মাইক্রো অর্গানিজমস বিলাকে কৰে ফিজিক্যাল নাইট্রোজেন ফিক্সেশন কেনেকে হয় লাইটনিংৰ কাৰণে হ'ব পাৰে ঠিক আছে লাইটনিং হ'ল ওপৰৰ পৰা মাছ পৰিলে নাইট্রোজেন আৰু কেনেকে হ'ব পাৰে ইন্ডাষ্ট্ৰিয়েল নাইট্রোজেন ফিক্সেশন হ'ব পাৰে ইন্ডাষ্ট্ৰিয়েল কেনেকে হ'ব পাৰে যে আমি কিছুমান ফার্টিলাইজার সয়লত মিক্স কৰো দিওঁ নে নিদিওঁ ফার্টিলাইজারবোৰ ক'ত বনায় ইন্ডাষ্ট্ৰিয়েল মানে ইউৰিয়া মাটিত মিক্স কৰে ৰাইট সো আলটিমেটলি ইউৰিয়াটো কি আছে নাইট্রোজেনটো আছে আলটিমেটলি ইউজেবল ফর্ম অফ নাইট্রোজেন যেটা আমি সয়লত পাম বা বনাম That is what is called as fixation. Generally, we talk about ki biological nitrogen fixation. Who is responsible? Microorganisms. But most common example that we read about is rhizobium and the roots of leguminous plants. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
ma'am. Okay. Next point is, ee je eneke lob koribo lage, kiho karone? Karon plants e ei bostuto lobo noare. Kiho lobo noare, jana? Karon tahate এই বন্ডটো ব্ৰেকডাউন কৰিব নোৱাৰে এই বন্ডটো ব্ৰেকডাউন কৰিব লাগিলে এটা স্পেচিফিক এনজাইম লাগিব ৰাইট নাইট্ৰোজিনেজ এই নাইট্ৰোজিনেজ এনজাইমটো প্লেন্ট চেলত নাথাকে ইট ইজ প্ৰেজেন্ট অনলি ইন মাইক্ৰো অৰ্গানিজমছ এণ্ড সো দ্য মাইক্ৰো অৰ্গানিজমছ কেন ব্ৰেক দিছ আৰু এইটো বন্ড যদি ব্ৰেক কৰো কি হ'ব নাইট্ৰোজেন ফ্ৰী হৈ যাব নাযায় এতিয়া মোক আৰু এটা আনসাৰ দিয়া প্লেন্টছক যে নাইট্ৰোজেন লাগে নাইট্ৰোজেন ক'ৰ পৰা পাব সয়লৰ পৰা পাব কোনটো ফৰ্মত এবজৰ্ব কৰিব নাইট্ৰেট এণ্ড নাইট্ৰাইট ৰাইট সো আলটিমেটলি আমি কি কওঁ নাইট্ৰেট নাইট্ৰাইট দুটা ৱৰ্ড পাইছো কোনটো ফৰ্মত এবজৰ্ব কৰে মই অলৰেডি লিখিয়ে দিলো ইন দ্য ফৰ্ম অফ নাইট্ৰেটছ এতিয়া এনএইচ থ্ৰী এনএইচ ফ'ৰ ৰাইট বা এনএইচ থ্ৰী এনএইচ ফ'ৰ হলে এমনিয়া হৈ যাব এই যে এন টু টু এনএইচ থ্ৰী লে কনভাৰ্ট কৰিব এইটো আছে এই বনটো ব্ৰেক কৰিলে বনটো ব্ৰেক কৰিব তাহাঁত ফ্ৰী হ'ল তেতিয়াহে হাইড্ৰজেন লগ লাগিব হয় নহয় যেতিয়ালৈকে বনটো ব্ৰেক নকৰে তেতিয়ালৈকে তাহাঁত ফ্ৰী নহয় আৰু যদি ফ্ৰী নহয় হাইড্ৰজেনৰ লগত কিয় পেয়াৰিং কৰিব ক্লিয়াৰ চ' আল্টিমেটলি এই ফৰ্মটোত নাইট্ৰেট ফৰ্মলৈ কনভাৰ্ট কৰা কোনটো কনভাৰ্ট কৰিছে এন টু কনভাৰ্ট কৰিছে এন টু দেট ৱাজ প্ৰেজেণ্ট ইন দ্য এটমছফিয়াৰ ইয়াতে কি ফৰ্মত আছে আলটিমেটলি নাইট্ৰেট নাইট্ৰেটক কোনে ল'ব প্লেণ্টছে এতিয়া এটমছফিয়াৰিক নাইট্ৰজেনটো ডাইৰেক্টলি নাইট্ৰেট ফৰ্ম নকৰে প্ৰথমতে কি ফৰ্ম কৰিব এমনিয়া এমনিয়াৰ পৰা কি ফৰ্ম কৰিব নাইট্ৰাইট নাইট্ৰাইটৰ পৰা কি ফৰ্ম কৰিব নাইট্ৰেট আর নাইট্রেট কোনে লব প্লান্টস এন্ড দিস ইজ হোয়াট ইজ কলড অ্যাজ বায়োলজিক্যাল নাইট্রোজেন ফিক্সেশন ক্লিয়ার রাইট এতিয়া এই প্রসেস টু যে এই যে অ্যামোনিয়া লে কনভার্ট হল অ্যামোনিয়া পর নাইট্রাইট লে কনভার্ট হল নাইট্রাইট টু নাইট্রেট লে কনভার্ট হল এই কনভার্সন কি কোনে করিব কিছুমান ব্যাকটেরিয়াই করিব আর এই ব্যাকটেরিয়া খিনি আমি কি বলি কইছো নাইট্রিফাইং ব্যাকটেরিয়া বলি কইছো ইজ আ পয়েন্ট ক্লিয়ার
Yes, ma'am.
Right? So, nitrifying bacteria part 2, very important. Nitrifying bacteria question kia hai? So, conversion of, duta conversion hoi na, moi ki kolu? Nitrogen to thaki bo, nitrogen to soil bo, loi bila ki form kori bo? Ammonia. Ama ki form lage? Nitrate lage. Kino ammonia ke nitrate directly form na kore? Nitrite form kore? Yate eta group of বেক্টেরিয়া লাগিব আর নাইট্রাইটের উপর নাইট্রেট ফর্ম করবলে আকো এটা গ্রুপ অফ বেক্টেরিয়াও লাগিব সো কোয়েশ্চন আহে দ্য বেক্টেরিয়া দ্যাট ইজ রেসপন্সিবল ফর দ্য কনভার্সন অফ অ্যামোনিয়া টু নাইট্রাইট দ্য গ্রুপ অফ বেক্টেরিয়া রেসপন্সিবল ফর কনভার্সন অফ নাইট্রাইট টু নাইট্রেট তার কি লিখিবা নাইট্রোসোমোনাস আর নাইট্রো vector. So jetia ami nitrifying bacteria boli ko, then we remember nitrosomonas and nitrobacter. Question kya hai? Ammonia to nitrite. Who is responsible for nitrosomonas and nitrobacter? So specifically ei duta ami porhibo leibo. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
তাতে ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট লিখিবা আৰু সালফাৰ বেক্টেৰিয়া এণ্ড আইৰণ বেক্টেৰিয়া যোনকেইটা হেৰি দি থৈছো এইটো কি কয় এক্সাম্পল দি থৈছো সেই এক্সাম্পলকেইটা পঢ়িলেই হৈ গ'ল এইটো পাৰ্টৰ পৰা কিবা কুৱেশ্যন আছে নেকি উই হেভ টকড এবাউট থ্ৰী লাইফ প্ৰচেছ গ্ৰ'থ গ্ৰ'থ আমি এটা পইণ্ট ভেৰি ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট কি ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট এছ শ্বেপড কাৰ্ভ চিগময়ড কাৰ্ভ ঠিক আছে আৰু তাৰ ফেজেছকেইটা Second, we have talked about respiration. Respiration is key important. Examples of obligate, examples of facultative, aerobic, anaerobic. How do we keep it? Nutrition. Nutrition is examples of important. Chemoautotrophs, chemoorganotrophs, photolithotrophs, photoorganotrophs. Right? Heterotrophic bacteria are examples. So, in this lesson, we have talked about examples. And out of the examples, nitrifying bacteria upor weird question aise iron bacteria upor weird question aise right so iron bacteria keta example disu ferrobacillus and leptotrichs disu neki
yes
right tar bitorot ferrobacillus question ke dekhe aise identify the iron bacteria in that case Ferrobacillus is not very commonly asked in the question because it is very simple. Everyone will know that since the word ferro is there, so obviously it is related with iron, so it's an iron bacteria. Because easy ho hetero chance kom thake. So you have to read about leptotrichs, right? So leptotrichs important bolii likhi thori hai as an example of iron bacteria, right? Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
So we have to move to the
ma'am facultative aerobes are example te seba koi dibo niki
kehor facultative aerobes are no facultative yes, aerobes means you are talking about chloronema facultative aerobes are facultative anaerobes
কোনোবা এৰোবছ হ'ব লাগে এটা মানে আপোনাৰ পিডিএফত হেৰিটো অহা নাছিলে ভালকে
ক্লৰবিয়াম ক্লৰবিয়াম লাষ্টটো ন
ইয়েছ মেম
ক্লৰবিয়াম
থেংক ইউ মেম
হল নাও The fourth life process, reproduction. Ako, the same dialogue, respiration bully kole two types, nutrition bully kole two types, reproduction bully kole broadly divided into asexual and sexual. In case of bacteria, what is the type of reproduction that you will find?
Asexual.
Asexual. Talking about asexual, no? Asexual bully kole asexual reproduction during favorable condition asexual reproduction during unfavorable condition duta term porhibo laibo favorable condition what is the most common method
binary fission
favorable condition kenuko dhorona asexual reproduction hobo
binary fission
binary fission and if you talk about unfavorable condition then
spore formation
right so the most common type of the type of reproduction seen in bacteria is asexual and talking about asexual these are the two types right favorable and unfavorable next point is sexual reproduction observed in bacteria ami sexual reproduction bacteria dekha paune na pao sexual reproduction boli kole ki hobo gamete form koribo libo bacteria gamete form kore niki
no ma'am
so sexual reproduction is absent in bacteria but one point that you have to remember sexual reproduction is absent in bacteria but a primitive type of sexual reproduction is seen where two bacteria shows exchange of genetic material. Did you get the line? Dutta sexual reproduction mane ki dutta gamete form kore a gamete gita fuse hoy adike ki ki hoy exchange of genetic material mane male or gamete female or gamete fuse kore zygote form kore to zygote tot ki thake dui tar combination thake na na thake
yes
right so it's almost we can say that there is a exchange of genetic material between two individuals yes or no
yes
in case of bacteria also we have seen the exchange of genetic material but gamete is not formed since gamete is not formed we cannot say sexual reproduction occurs but we can say there is a type of sexual reproduction that is called as sexual recombination which is seen in case of bacteria is the point here sexual reproduction present absent absent key present sexual recombination present sexual recombination क्योंकि है अ प्रिमिटिव टाइप ऑफ सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इज अ पॉइंट क्लियर
मैम गैमेट फॉर्म नकरा को सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन हो जाए
सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन न होय सेक्सुअल रिकॉम्बिनेशन होय गैमेट फॉर्म न करिले केतिया सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन होबोय नवारे बैक्टीरिया गैमेट फॉर्म न करे से कारणे सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन एब्सेंट কিন্তু দুটা ব্যাকটেরিয়া তার নিজৰ নিজৰ জেনেটিক মেটেৰিয়েল কিনে এক্সচেঞ্জ কৰে এখানে এই প্ৰসেছটোক আমি কি বুলি কৈছো সেক্সুৱেল ৰিকম্বিনেশ্বন বুলি কৈছো ক্লিয়াৰ
yes ma'am
right okay
yes,
so asexual reproduction yes আৰু কি পইণ্ট সেক্সুৱেল ৰিপ্ৰডাকচন no সেক্সুৱেল ৰিকম্বিনেশ্বন yes sexual recombination ami ki dekha pao exchange of genetic material and within this process we have to talk about three process that is transduction or meiosis transformation conjugation and transduction asexual reproduction or sexual recombination sexual recombination key point inter process transformation conjugation or transduction talking about asexual reproduction the most common method is obviously binary fission and I don't think we need to explain anything about binary fission hai to sabhi jane udaharan ke liye kya ko any student having any doubt in binary fission please ask me What happens in binary fission? You have a cell, you have the nucleus elongates, right? And then, dutta nuclei form kore, cytoplasm constrict kore, and ultimately we have two cell. This is binary fission in very simple language. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Right. So in favorable condition, bacteria bilake ki kore, they are reproduced by means of binary fission. But during unfavorable condition, we see spore formation, and one of the most common spore that is seen is endospore so question hai endospore formation is seen in endospore formation is seen in bacteria right next first endospore ki hoy eta spore ketia form korese unfavorable condition so obviously etu ki hobo clear thik hoy unfavorable survive koribo lagile in and around they have to synthesize a thick wall so thick walled spores are always the spores that are formed in unfavorable condition right and next unfavorable condition of form koise jehetu tantar ta ki thakibo yes or no
yes ma'am
next another point unfavorable condition of form koise so they have to be very yes or no
yes
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 right if they are not resistant then obviously the bacteria will not be able to survive the unfavorable condition so the endospore that is formed is considered as a highly resistant structure this highly resistant structure is said to be highly resistant because of the presence of a certain chemical that is called as calcium, DP, collinate. So A spore to ki thake? When we are talking about the spore, ekon jodi spore wall hoy, tar next layer to ami ki boli kobo paro cortex. So in the cortex, a specific chemical is present that is called as calcium DP collinate, which makes the endospore a highly resistant structure. Is the point here?
Yes.
Yes, or no? Ki ho karne resistant? Kan A2 ase. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
And because of the presence of this, so calcium DP collinate thakai karne endospore to ki hoise? Highly resistant hoise. Right. Another property hoise, because of the presence of this, the bacteria that develops nature by property. Anticoagulant nature. Because of this. Now, what is anticoagulant? Anticoagulant, but there, what is coagulation? Coagulation ki bostu?
Gutmarizwa.
Proteins, when they are exposed to high temperature, what happens? They coagulate. We can give the best example as the egg in a fry pan. Right? Frying pan at egg to thodle ki hobo. What is called as coagulant. We know inside the bacteria there are so many proteins, right? We have already talked about the different types of proteins that is present in the plasma membrane. Next sentence that we have said is bacteria is also present in any environmental condition. There are certain bacteria that are found in very high temperature regions also. So iman gorom jagat he bacteria told into proteins ase. Proteins kini ki koribo lagisile? Coagulate koribo lagisile? Lagisile na lagisile? High temperature protein, what happened? It should coagulate, but it does not get coagulated because of the presence of calcium DP collinate in the cortex. Is the point here?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Right? So, this is what we are going to wind up the class for today, right? We have talked about the life process of bacteria, right? Shapes of bacteria, flagella, and the number of flagella and the types of flagella, the words related, right? Sexual recombination is something that we are going to study in the next class. And whenever we talk about sexual recombination, we are going to talk about the three types, conjugation, transformation, and transaction. And by that, we'll be completing our Monera, I mean, eubacteria part of Monera. Pasta pori bole gibo, no? Eubacteria, last part to, I mean, next class of it. Any questions?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Would you pass to?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. I think that's all for today. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome.